Hi, Kevin Torgerson with the Olmsted County Sheriff's Office. Can you believe it? 2020 has come to an end. I reviewed our end of year comments from last year, and little did we know how the wonderful events and activities that connect us with our communities would be affected by the unpredictability of 2020. Two international challenges with COVID-19 and civil unrest affected everything related to our community engagement that we depend on so much to support our communities. COVID-19 forced us to pull out our continuity of operations plans, activate Emergency Operations Center, and force us to curtail so many normal day-to-day and annual engagements. It's created challenges in keeping our detainees and detention facilities safe and protected from the virus, as well as our staff, so that they could continue being able to serve and protect our communities, both in the detention facilities as well as in the squad on the streets. We collaborated to release low-level offenders and provide space to separate persons that are not able to leave detention, worked to continue doing gun permits for purchase and carry, and supported the courts and government center to continue due process of our justice system. Our law enforcement side of the office was largely unaffected as they continued to respond to calls for service to help no matter the case. As civil unrest grew across the country a couple months later, we worked immediately to affirm our commitment to our communities of all backgrounds and look forward to working to regain the trust some lost in law enforcement. We heard from our communities both in the support of law enforcement and those questioning our training and tactics. We are thankful for the great relationships we have forged over the years, as we have and hope to engage more in the future. We heard requests to change and respond to legislative reform, which allowed us to present to our communities the progressive work we have been doing for years and are ahead of most agencies in Minnesota, if not the country, in that regard. We know we have more work to do and look forward to the return of opportunities in the future for enhancing training, community engagement, and support. My hope is our communities will be willing to join with us as we grow, learn, and that they take time to engage in honest and open dialogue with the goal that we should all agree on: public safety for all of us. I want to thank those who have worked tirelessly through the pandemic as we prepare for vaccinations. Our healthcare and public health folks, EMS, and other public safety staff. I also encourage you to support those that have had restrictions on their work and businesses throughout this trying time, however you are able. We look forward to meeting with you again at some point in 2021, as we're hopeful restrictions lessen and we are free to move about. Look for us locally at the many community events and organizations we support. Like the Olmsted County Fair, throughout the past summer, these fairgrounds were turned into a COVID-19 testing site. We hope that this summer, it will turn back into a fairground for people to enjoy like it was originally intended. We also look forward to community celebrations throughout the summer, Safe City Nights here in Rochester, and National Night Out throughout Olmsted County. We can't wait to get back into the schools and be part of their educational experiences. DARE classes and graduations, career fairs, and other classroom visits are very important to our office. We stand ready to get back to all the events, activities, and festivals that support numerous nonprofits throughout Olmsted County. For example, the Polar Plunge and other events that support Special Olympics. We are also eager to get back to business in many other facets that serve our citizens, like our prescription drug take-back days. Every year at this time, as we approach the new year, it brings hope and promise for better days ahead. Our world couldn't be more ready to turn the page on 2020, but we must be mindful of what we learned from our past in hopes of not repeating it. Turning the page doesn't mean we go back to our old ways. It should mean we learn and build on our past experiences to improve our future and that of our children and grandchildren. Thanks for joining me today. Be well and be safe.